by the U.S. Army Band and Choir. Please, everybody, would y'all like to stand, please?
Father, we come before you with a grateful heart. And Father, we thank you for all you've given us. Father, we thank you that we still live in the land of the free and the home of the brave, and that we're still a free country, Father, and that we are a country that honors you. And Father, I just thank you for the food we've received. Father, we thank you for everything you've given us. And once again, Father, we ask for wisdom. Wisdom in the days ahead, because your word tells us that you know the beginning from the end. And we need to have wisdom for the upcoming years and the upcoming days. And Father, once again, we thank you for just your protection. And we plead the blood over the workers and over the farmers as they go and harvest their crops. Lord, we just thank you just for being a good God. And we just give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Here. 79 years strong this co-op is, and I think that says a lot about the people and the community that we have here tonight. With that, we'll go ahead and start down the business part of the meeting that we have to get accomplished. And so the first thing that we do every year at the annual meeting is we have to have a motion to approve any members that have been connected from August 1st to today. And so I'm going to announce the new members that have been connected. We have six new members: Templeton Mortgage Corporation, Maria and Alfredo Tovar, Wildcat Ranch Wind Project, Steve or Dolores Mosser, Maria Quintanilla, and Ramona Robles. And with that, I would entertain a motion for the membership to approve these new members of our co-op. And I have a motion. Do I have a second? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Any of you are here, welcome to the co-op family. Next, I'm going to call on Jerry Nichols, who's going to do our roll call.
Hey, Jerry. Well, as far as the roll call, no, we don't have to do the roll call because we do have a quorum, so that's not necessary. As far as the notices of this meeting today, I, Jerry Nichols, affirm that I am elected and acting secretary of Bailey County Electric Cooperative Association. On the first day of this month, August 2018, the cooperative mailed to each member of the cooperative a notice of this meeting, this annual meeting of the members to be held today, Tuesday, August the 28th. And also at this time, it's for the reading of the minutes of last year's annual meeting, which doesn't, I mean, we can't dispense with that. And if someone would raise their hand to make that motion, hey, right there, good. Is there a second? A second somewhere? Okay, good. Y'all did it just right. Okay, all in favor of this, please, y'all give your hand.
They're only about 14 pages long, so I always hope that y'all will approve dispensing that. One of these days we should make him read them. Next I'm going to call on Jack Moss to give our financial report. Jack is with the CPA firm of Bollinger Segers, Gilbert and Moss.
I can attest to the fact that Jamey's been around a long time because I've seen her since she was about this high, so she's telling you right. I get a kick out of asking this every place I go, and it's dwindling down some. How many of you in here can remember not having electricity at your place? There's a few. Thank goodness we're dwindling away. They're getting fewer and further between, but I'm kind of like Jamey in Electric Co-op. Linegar Electric brought power to our farm when I was in about the seventh grade. And I can remember immediately what a difference it made. And, you know, even doing your homework by a 40-watt light bulb was an improvement. But all the other things that happened. I'm going to be referring to the condensed financial statement that is in your program. Our firm has been the auditor for Bailey County Electric for a number of years. It's a great bunch of people to work with. Your board of directors is very conscientious, and they can report to you that they look after your business. The way they should. Your books and records are in excellent condition. They're kept in accordance with all generally accepted accounting principles and all the other principles that would seem like we're presented with another principle every day, this day and time, but your folks are taking excellent care of your business. The financial statement, I'll not read all the figures of from the cash to other investments, accounts receivable, your plant at a depreciated value of $55 million. Now that's original cost, less depreciation, has no relationship to replacement cost or market value. Market value doesn't matter because it's not for sale. Then other assets, your total assets are $50,979,000. Your equity in the system is some $38 million, which is a 42, almost 43% equity in the system. You're indebted to REFC for $50 million. And the CFC representative is here tonight. Maybe he won't foreclose on us tonight because, you know, our depreciated value of our plant is $55 million. We just owe $50 million, so maybe he'll let us keep it for another weekend. But as far as the income, your total income was $29 million. Your expenses were $28 million. The expenses were just over $29 million. We had a loss this year, as sometimes happens in the agricultural business or in the business that your cooperative is involved in. But this year, 2018 has recovered. You're very strong. And even with this situation here, your cooperative is in very strong, in a very strong position, and you have some financial statements that you can have confidence in and you should be proud of. There's a lot of information in here, even about employees and length of service. Some of these people don't seem to hang around too long. So I see one in here, some guy's been here 41 years, and there's several others. And that's a tribute to your organization and a tribute to the kind of organization you have. Again, it's our pleasure to serve as the auditor for your cooperative. Your financial records are in good shape. You're in good shape financially. Be happy to answer any questions you might have, or if not now, we'll later at some point. Thank you.
One thing I failed to do earlier is let's thank our entertainment that we have. Taya Lachey and Lucas, what a great job they did performing for us. So how about a round of applause for them? Next, I'm going to call on Matt Davis, who is the chairman of our nominating committee, to give our report on nominations.
Good evening. As she said, my name is Matt Davis, and I'm the chair of this year's nominating committee. We met June 5th and gathered nominations for the two districts that are up for re-election this year. Our committee consisted of Kyle Stansel, Gary Glover, Kirby Birch, myself, and Tommy Kirk. District 1, the nominations are Daryl Stevens and Ronnie Altman. And for District 2, the nominations are Keith Hicks and Cody Kirby. Thank you.
We appreciate that nominating committee for the work that they put into it. Election of directors is one of the most important things we do every year at the annual meeting. And so with that being said, you have been presented before you the nominees that were recommended, or nominations that were made by the nominating committee. But pursuant to our bylaws, additional nominations can also be made from the floor. And so with that, I'm going to entertain any additional nominations for these two director spots that we may have from the floor. So if at this time anybody has any additional nominations that they would like to make, I would entertain those. Going once? Anybody? Last chance? Okay, there being no nominations from the floor, then I'm going to declare that nominations cease. And so with that, we have the listed nominees for the two director spots. And I would like to take this opportunity to introduce these guys to you before we do the election. And so for district number, and when I call your name, if you would please stand and wave so everybody can see you are and stay standing. For district number 1, we have Daryl Stevens and Ronnie Altman. And for district number 2, we have Keith Hicks and Cody Kirby. Okay, thank you. thank y'all. And thank you to all of these gentlemen for agreeing to be nominees and be willing to serve the cooperative. With that, it is now time that I need to appoint our election judges. And those are the guys that are going to count our ballots. And with that, and they will gather once we get to that point, but let me go ahead and introduce them. We have LeAnn Gallman, Larry Shields, Mike Smith, and Deanne Allen. I'm going to ask these election judges to check the ballot boxes, and they will gather those. Each member should have been given a ballot that looks like this. You can't vote for another member. We don't allow voting by proxy, so only the member is allowed to vote. You vote for one candidate in each district. So you vote for one candidate in district number one and one candidate in district number two. And so with that said, I'm going to ask the members to pull out the vote, the ballots that you were given, and if everyone will cast their vote at this time. One for district number one and one for district number two. Once you have done that, if you will hold your ballots up, the election committee or the election judges will gather all of the ballots and retire to count those. So does anybody have any questions on the voting? One vote, one time for each district. We'll give them a chance to work around the room. See which areas to go. Make sure we don't miss anybody. Okay, are we missing anybody? Does anybody wave real high if we haven't gotten your ballot? Here's one more up here that we need to get. Okay, anybody else? Wave it high if we have failed to pick up your ballot. We have everybody? Okay, with that, the election judges will retire to the back, and I'm going to turn it over to David Marricle, who's going to introduce some guests.
Difference a year makes. Last year we had to have motorboats and rowboats to make it into the annual meeting, and this year I had to isolate it in here, so glad you could be here on a beautiful Tuesday night. Before I begin, I have been given strict instructions by my wife Terry and my administrative assistant Ricky Warren not to tell any stories or jokes. To try to stay on the script. And so sorry, Rusty, I can't tell your joke. So if anybody wants to hear Rusty's joke, y'all get with him. So if I come across boring, I tried. So. All right, it's my privilege and pleasure to introduce our guest tonight. However, before I do that, I want to personally welcome you and to thank you, our member owners, for attending the 79th annual meeting of Beta County Electric Cooperative. We are very grateful for the opportunity to serve you and appreciate your service and your support and patronage over the years. It's now time to introduce some guests tonight. First of all, the fella going around with the camera taking pictures tonight is from our statewide organization, the Texas Electric Co-op in Austin. His name is Charles Lorman. And we're glad that he's here. He's the editor of Texas Co-op Power. Then we have Meg Ann and Gil Reynolds from Channel 6 down here videotaping. We're glad they could be here. Meg Ann is married to Jack Reynolds. Jack Reynolds was a longtime employee for us. You met LeAnn Gallman. She was one of the election judges. She's the mayor or the manager of the city of Muleshoe. Then we have Rod Palmer from the State Line Tribune in Farwell, but he's here. Michael Smith, he's back with the election judges counting. He is one of our engineers from SDS Engineering, named Michael Smith. And then we have several from Golden Spread, our wholesale power supplier. Larry Shields, he's back counting votes. John Eichelmann will be on the program. He's somewhere around in there, he is. And then LeAnn Moore back there counting votes too. So we're proud to think you'd be here tonight. You've already heard Jack Moss, our auditor from Voting Procedures, Gilbert Moss. byJack had come out. He's kind of, he's trying to retire, but they won't let him work. They can't get him out of the office. I'm not real sure how it works. But anyway, I'd like for Jack to be here all the time. Our banker, Jeff Butler from CFC, he's here to make sure I'm spending the money right. And I've already mentioned Dan Allen from Golden Spread. We have some guests from our neighboring co-op, Lamb County Electric Co-op. We have Sue Williamson. We have Lupe Marquez. And then Kathy Shipp, right there. And then also have a director from over there, Doug and Darla Criswell here. Appreciate y'all being here. Now I'd like to introduce some of our ex-employees that are here tonight. We have Frank and Shug McCamish. We have a longtime employee for us, a wife here, Barbara McCamish, who is the wife of Clark McCamish, who's a longtime employee for us. Glad she could be here tonight. We have Billy and Bob Graves. Billy was the office manager for us for years. And we have Tisha Boning here tonight. She was also an office manager for us, supervisor last year. And we have Gerald and Ogling Pruitt. And then we have Bill Crenshaw. Is there anybody else that I've missed as ex-employees? We have some directors. I have Nelson and Nancy Carlisle, who's ex-director, and Judy and Tommy Kirk, ex-directors. Anybody else? That's all I've got. I had signed up, so appreciate y'all being here tonight. Next, I would like to introduce our board of directors of the co-op. And starting with Daryl Stevens and his wife, Eva Dean. Daryl represents District 1 in the West Camp and Progress areas and also serves as the chairman of the board. He also serves on the Golden Spread Electric Board in Amarillo. And Daryl has been a director since 1988, 30 years. Representing District 2 is Keith Hicks and his wife, Lynn. Keith represents the Lansbury and Muleshoe areas and serves as the vice president. And Keith has been a director since 2000. From District 3 is Greg Welch and his wife Kelly. Greg represents the Earth and Dot Sunnyside areas and has been a board member since 2014. From District 4 is Jerry Nichols and his wife Suzanne. Jerry serves as our secretary treasurer and they represent the Needmore area. And Jerry's been director since 1992. Representing District 5 is Ronnie Barrett and his wife Sherry. No, I've tried to give him a different wife from time before. But anyway, Ronnie served the Goodland and Michael areas, and Ronnie's been a director since 2013. From District 6, we have Keith Layton and Julie. Keith represents the Beulah and Phoenix areas, and he served on our board since 2008. And last but not least is good friend Larry Clawson and his wife Karen. They represent District 7 and is the Morton, Bledsoe, and Lehman areas, and has served on the board since 2008. Now these directors, they have a challenging job because directing and leading an electric co-op has become a very complex task. They do a great job because they are fully dedicated to the well-being of this cooperative. Please join with me and show our appreciation for the job they do. Thank you. Now, don't believe my wife out. I'd like to introduce my wife, Terry. She's up front. Who is my main support and is always there for me whenever I need help or advice, and she tries to keep me on task. I'll try to stay on task tonight. One of the proudest moments I have at our annual meetings is when I get to recognize the employees of Bay County Electric Co-op. You know, we have new processes and technologies that help make our jobs easier and better, but it still comes down to the employees of the co-op to get the job done. They are a great team of individuals, and it would be difficult to manage this cooperative without them. We currently have 41 employees, which are 3 less than we had last year at this time, and with approximately 694 years of service. That's about an average of approximately 17 years per employee. We currently have 8 employees who have more than 30 years of service to the cooperative, with 4 of those having over 40 years. Their names and years of service are listed on the back of your program. They are the heart and soul of this cooperative, and it is my privilege and honor to be able to introduce them to you tonight. Thank you, guys. Next, I would like to recognize an employee who has successfully completed the National Rural Electric Cooperative Association, NRECA, Supervisory Program. NRECA is our national organization. This individual is receiving a certificate for completing the required 9 course supervisory curriculum that is designed to address the leadership, communication, and basic administrative skills needed to manage people more effectively by new supervisors or for those who may move into a supervisor position at a later date. Receiving her certificate tonight is Suzie Brown. Suzie has been the senior key accounts manager for the cooperative and has been with us for almost 3 years now. Certificate is presented to Suzie Brown in recognition of having successfully completed the NRECA supervisory program. Also, Suzie is also receiving another certificate. Is a certified cooperative communicator certificate for having demonstrated through course study and examination plus work experience a professional level of knowledge and skill in electric cooperative communications. And please join me in congratulating Suzie for her dedication and hard work for her achievements. And this says, is hereby designated a certified cooperative communicator by virtue of having demonstrated the examination work performance at a professional level of knowledge and skill in electric cooperative communications. And she received this back on May 2018, but I've been making her wait until now. Who has done an outstanding job for the past 25 to 30 years. Our annual meetings don't just happen overnight. It takes a great deal of planning and organizing to ensure that the annual meeting is a success, and Ricky Warren has been instrumental in making that happen. She don't know, she doesn't know I'm doing this, you know, because that's the one most times I went on script, so she has no clue what I'm doing. Ricky has announced that this is her last annual meeting as she plans to retire in 2019. She's been a very valuable employee to Bailey County Electric and a good friend to me throughout the years. She will be very difficult to replace. Please help me in honoring Ricky at this time. You're arguing with me. Yep, she's been my work wife for over 30 years, but she's been planning annual meetings for 25 to 30 years. So. I'm not going to tell you how old she is, but she probably won't be. Okay. By now, you probably had a chance to read my report in front of the program about adjusting rates in 2017. So I'm going to be very brief. I don't like to talk about rates. But the financial statement in your program shows that the cooperative's margins were almost $1.3 million in the red. Simply stated, our expenses were higher than our income, so we had negative margins for the year. As was stated in the report, there's a cost in building and maintaining our system to provide our members with dependable service, dependable electric service, and those costs continue to increase every year. When you look at the pie chart on the financial page of your program, you can see how our expenses are broken down. Bailey County Electric can only control approximately 8 to 10% of those expenses. We make every attempt to control those expenses, but they are only a small portion of our overall expenses. The other 90% of the expenses is the cost of doing business, with wholesale power costs being our largest expense at this time. We are very fortunate, however, that we are members of Gallman Spread Electric Cooperative because our wholesale power rates could be higher. It could be 15, 16, 17 cents a kilowatt hour. The Gallman Spread has done a great job in helping to keep our costs down. So after watching our overall margins decline the past 3 years, time finally came to adjust our rates. That's what 2017 will be remembered for. However, even though we had to make adjustments to the rates, our cost for electric service still remains a good value when you compare it to goods and service that have also increased at a higher rate over the past few years. I told you I'd be brief. However, if you have any questions or comments, because I don't want to push anybody off or put anybody off, regarding rates or anything else, please feel free to come by the office and I will be glad to visit with you. Thank you. That concludes my report, and I will now call Suzie Brown to come up here to give us an update on the government and action leader.
In 1965, Bailey County Electric began sending area students to Washington, D.C. on the NRECA Government in Action Youth Tour. Over the years, Bailey County has sent over 59 students on this trip of a lifetime. The tour has grown to include over 1,500 students from all over the nation. 2018 proved to be a banner year for Texas, and that we sent over 150 students representing our state. We sent two delegates to represent our co-op. They were Yvonne Diaz and Michaela Merrigan. They began their trip in Austin, and they visited the Capitol, the Bullock Museum, and the State Cemetery. They then traveled to Washington, where they visited the memorials, attended a performance at the Kennedy Center, were treated to an evening cruise on the Potomac River, and watched a sunset parade on the Potomac by the Marine Corps Band at the Iwo Jima Memorial. They were also able to spend a day on Capitol Hill meeting with their elected officials. They toured the Holocaust Museum, the Smithsonian Museum, the National Cathedral, and they witnessed the wreath-laying ceremony at the Arlington National Cemetery. What these delegates were able to see and experience in 1 week was both exciting and exhausting. They packed more into this week than they had ever done, and they came back pretty tired, but pretty excited. If any of you know of a high school student that would be interested in this, watch our Facebook page. We'll be posting that later in the fall, and how they can apply and possibly represent our co-op. Both of our delegates were seniors this last year, so they are off at college, but we would like to show you just a quick little video to show you what their experience was like.
Signatures on the Constitution, it's amazing.
So many opportunities, get so many monuments, learn a tremendous amount of things, and just make completely new friends. They could be lifelong best friends, and if you wouldn't have came on this trip, you'd have never met them.
Really, it's your history books coming to life. It's one of the best experiences ever, and you make the best of friends.
It's just a really great experience. Like, apply, do the essay, do the interview, do whatever you can.
This is an opportunity of a lifetime.
It's a trip of a lifetime.
It's really a trip of a lifetime.
This is a trip of a lifetime.
This is a trip of a lifetime.
It's truly a trip of a lifetime.
This is a trip of a lifetime.
Are eligible for this trip, 32, 33 years ago, I went on the trip. There's others in this room that I know have been on the trip as well, and they're all exactly right. It's a trip of a lifetime, and it's an opportunity that kids from schools that we serve don't have an opportunity to do, except for that our co-op has given them this opportunity. So it's a great thing, and so I'm going to add an extra plug that encourage participation, because it is really, really a trip of a lifetime. That said, I'm going to move down the agenda, and I'm going to call on John Eichelmann, who is the Vice President of Member Services for Golden Spread Electric, and he is going to give their report.
Thank you. So Golden Spread is an electric cooperative
made up of 16 distribution members, Bailey County, of course, being one of those members. We had a record year this year. In July, we served the most electricity of any month, both in kilowatt-hour sales and in peak demand. I'm happy to report tonight that your power plants that you all own performed great, and we're able to keep our overall costs and rates low to you all. So we couldn't have done that without the vision and the direction that our board of directors have provided. Two of those board of directors are from your cooperative, and that was David Marricle and Bill Schreiber. So without those participants and representing you on that board, we couldn't have put together the successful strategy that we were able to be able to pass those rates on to you. So without further ado, I do believe we have a video that will further go into our strategy. And you'll recognize one of the stars. He's back there counting the votes tonight. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask Larry Shields. He's here tonight.
The Golden Spread Electric Cooperative footprint is massive, covering 24% of Texas and parts of three other states. In the last few years, this region has been transformed by all the wind farms taking advantage of abundant natural resources so prevalent in our area. Driving through, we see spinning blades on many turbines during the day and blinking red lights at night. Also popping up more and more are solar projects. We are seeing our service territory grow into the title of Renewable Energy Capital of the World. Against this backdrop, Golden Spread spent 2017 refining our approach and being responsive to this great opportunity provided by low-cost renewable energy. To tell you about a few of the ways we are responsive to the changes in this environment, here's Larry Shields from our Member Services Department.
Promoting electrification has the potential to provide many economic and environmental benefits to our local communities. Our generation plan is centered around taking advantage of the vast renewable energy resources. Golden Spread's vision is to deliver competitive energy solutions. And to achieve that vision, we have four strategies. Let's talk about those four strategies and the ways we are refining our approach to deliver competitive energy solutions. First is operational excellence. Taking care of the investment our members have made in Golden Spread, 2017 was a historic year for Golden Spread. For more on that, let's hear from Carrie Hollingsworth.
Over the last several years, Golden Spread invested in new power plants as a way to replace the power we were purchasing from other suppliers. When the power supply agreements expired at the end of May 2017, Golden Spread, for the first time in its history, supplied all of its member needs without the support of direct purchases from investor-owned utilities, one of which had supplied power to some of our members since they were formed. Your new Quick Start natural gas-fired plants blend well with the abundant wind energy available in our area, allowing us to take advantage of the cheap available wind energy while providing reliable electric supply.
We made a large investment in our generating plants, and now it's our job to keep an eye on the ball and be sure these assets are as productive as possible. Last year, we completed a staff reorganization and established an enterprise risk management system. Aligning our staff and managing risk are large efforts that move us towards our operational excellence goals. And more importantly, serving you, our members and owners. Our second strategy is load growth. In 2017, we won a bid to add load from one of our members, TCEC, which is currently under a contract with another supplier for a portion of its load that Golden Spread does not currently serve. Let's hear from Zach Perkins, Chief Executive Officer of TCEC.
The TCEC had an expiring wholesale contract for about 45% of its load. That wholesale supplier had informed TCEC that they would no longer be providing that load in 2021, so we had to find a power supplier. The board of TCEC felt that it was in the membership's best interest to become a wholly subscribed member with Golden Spread Electric. They provided us a very good competitive rate. For Golden Spread was a little bit long on resources. So bringing this load into Golden Spread allows more units for fixed prices to be spread across, which benefits all the Golden Spread members. So this really was a win-win situation for everybody involved.
Our third strategy deals with what's called distributed energy resources. We believe distributed energy resources have the potential to be integrated into the overall Golden Spread resource operations, as long as they don't require cost subsidies from other member consumers. Another strategic focus is member services. Our board directed Golden Spread staff to explore opportunities to extend value-added service to our members. An initial focus of this effort is IT-related services. We believe achieving the four strategic goals is the best way to meet our goal of being flexible, competitive, and your trusted energy supplier.
As you can see, we continue refining our operations and being responsive to our members. We always keep in mind that we are here to serve our members and provide a secure energy future for generations to come. We are grateful for the privilege of serving you. Thank you.
Thank you, Golden Spread. Are our election judges back? Now we'll get a report from the chairman of the election judges as the results of the election.
Election of the membership, District 1 will be Ronnie Altman, District 2 will be Keith Hicks.
Thank you for your service to the committee. And with that, is there any other business? Besides the fact that I know I'm standing between some pretty good looking door prizes and the audience, is there any other business to come before the meeting today? If not, then I will turn the door prizes over to Ruth, and then following that, the meeting will be adjourned.
Our gift card from the Nietzsche Group Insurance, and that was Kathy Ship from Lamb County Electric. She's right over here. Next up, we have a desktop wind tower fan donated by Texas Electric Cooperative. Donnie McDonald. Where's Donnie McDonald at? Sorry, y'all gonna have to really raise your hands. We can't see you very well. Thank you. A Hamilton Beach blender donated by Texas Electric Cooperative goes to Lucy Perez. A Black and Decker toaster oven donated by Amarella Electric Service to Michael Richards. A blood pressure monitor donated by Bailey County Electric Cooperative goes to Ben Rose.